Do you want to make a video to share your science, but think it is too difficult or time-consuming or requires special equipment and training? In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how easy it is to plan, shoot, edit, and share a video using just your smartphone. So let's get started. First and foremost, you need a plan. Basically, you want to begin your video project by deciding what your main message is going to be. Starting with a laundry list of objectives or results will just confuse the viewer. Instead of presenting a series of facts, try to tell a story by putting your information into a historical context, or in the form of a mystery or puzzle, or by telling how your work benefits society. And be sure to tailor your story for your intended audience. The easiest way to organize your material is to have a beginning, a middle, and an end. The beginning is where you want to hook the viewer and set the tone of the video. You can ask an interesting question and let your story unfold like a mystery novel. In the middle is your main content, where you will cover the main points. At the end, tie everything together and perhaps explain the significance of what the viewer has just seen. The next step is to create a script and storyboard to help you explain your material with a minimum of technical jargon and in the most concise way possible. A script or even a brief outline can help you stay on track and avoid digressions. A storyboard, which can be created in PowerPoint, is a visual sequence of steps that summarizes what media to use for each video segment, where to film, and what perspectives to use. Once you have a plan, you are ready to film. You need a phone with a camera that shoots video and will also work with the software you will use to edit the footage. Smartphones have excellent cameras that will shoot high-definition video and are easy to use. I'll be using an iPhone for this demonstration, but the general principles apply to other devices. Of course, you can use other cameras such as the GoPro Hero for filming in wet or underwater situations, or combined with a drone for aerial footage. Accessories can greatly improve the quality of your video. Use a tripod or monopod to stabilize your camera, especially if you are filming solo. Special mounts to hold cell phones are inexpensive and work with most tripods. A selfie stick will let you walk around filming yourself while explaining your material. Good audio is critical. In general, you want to select shooting locations without distracting noise such as traffic or other loud sounds. A lapel microphone will help ensure the person speaking on camera is heard clearly above any ambient noise. This one has a jack that fits into a cell phone. Next, shoot some footage. You want to film yourself explaining your research or film interviews with colleagues or students. A video consisting solely of talking heads is boring, however. Instead, film activities in various settings and from different perspectives, and to illustrate different aspects of your work. You can film procedures and equipment, for example. You can also shoot footage or still images of plants, animals, the landscape, and other scenes. These can be used in montage sequences in your video. Once you've shot your footage, you are ready to edit. There are excellent movie editing apps for mobile devices such as iMovie. When you open the app and start a new movie project, you will see a simple interface where you will build your video. Access your photo and video library by tapping the plus sign. Then select the clip you want and tap the plus sign again. The footage drops into the timeline. Then continue to add clips like this to build your project. So let's select a couple more to add this one, and let's add this one. You can move clips around in a different sequence by dragging and dropping. Trimming clips is just as easy. After selecting the clip, Dragging the yellow bars will cut off the footage at either end of the clip. Now let's add some photos, which are stored in my photo library. Just tap on one and it automatically drops into the timeline. So let's add another photo. And let's add one more. Now you can add motion to your photos with a Ken Burns effect, and this is really easy to do. Text titles are also easily added by selecting the text tool and then the type of title you need. A text box appears, and all you do is just retype your title. So now the text appears superimposed on the clip when you play it. You may want to record a voiceover for your video. To do this, select Voiceover in the Media Library, which opens up the recording option. Then all you do is tap record and you get a 3-second countdown and the recording starts. You then have the option to retake or accept the recording. When finished, you can preview your video full screen by going back to the marquee screen and tapping the play button. The final step is to save and share your video, or you can upload directly to YouTube or another video sharing site, or you can post it on your website. This brief look at video making was designed to show you how easy it is. For more detailed tutorials on filming and editing with mobile devices, see the links in the video description below.